Ian Martinelli from Class 5-1. I have the honor of leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand and remain standing afterwards for the Star Spangled Banner. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Joining us here today for the Pines 2024 Stepping Up Ceremony. I would first like to thank Dr. DiMuzio, Ms. Byer, and all of the office staff and all the teachers who have helped us get to this point. I would also like to thank the custodians and security guards for keeping our school clean and safe. This year, along with all the past years, has greatly impacted my life. Let's take a quick look back to capture some highlights. In kindergarten, I had so much fun in the circus. I was a lion and got to jump through the ring of fire. I bet you all remember what you were for the circus. I also remember my Uncle Marty came to the Veterans Day ceremony and we got to thank him and all the veterans for their service to our country. First grade is when I learned to read well and we all got to watch the Chicks Hatch. But then COVID hit and we had to do school on the computer. I didn't love it, but we got through it. Moving on to second grade. We had to sit behind plastic shields and sit 6 feet from each other. I had a wonderful teacher. We were still wearing masks when we started third grade, but we went around visiting the classes and learning about different countries. We even put on fairy tale plays for our families. My play was about the little red hen. In the fourth grade, I started loving math and got to be in the math enrichment class. We went on a fishing trip and even had a snowball fight in the class. It was cool when we debated the American Revolution. I was a redcoat. Now we are in our last year, fifth grade. We took memorable trips to Adventure Park, Adventureland, and City Field with Miss Ray Dolgen to sing the national anthem. Thanks to Mr. Rose, I also enjoyed playing the drums in concerts and working on art projects with Mrs. A and Mrs. Catavana. Become the president. I am really proud of each member of the student council for all their hard work and for what we were able to bring to Hopog this year, such as theme days, and for what we were able to give back to students to enjoy the years to come. We raised $350 by selling sports keychains and stickers. We raised the funds to buy indoor recess equipment like board games, cars, and a toss and catch game. From now on, when we have indoor recess, kids will have something fun to do. We also organized a blood drive at Forest Brook. People came to donate blood to help those in need, and members of the student council volunteered greeting donors, giving out snacks, and ensuring the event ran smoothly. Recently, members of the Student Council welcomed the incoming kindergartners and their families to the Pines during orientation. They guided the new students around the school, showing them their future classrooms, special classes like art, music, gym, and library, and even explaining what a cafetorium is. They answered questions, made the kids smile, and reassured them that they will love the school just like we do. My classmates and I will really miss the school, but I am looking forward to middle school, making new friends, and reconnecting with the friends from Forest Brook and Bretton Woods. I know this is a big step, but I also know we are ready and will continue to make a positive impact moving forward. Thank you and congratulations, Pines Elementary Class of 2024.
Hello, my name is Gia Gerso from Class 5th grade. Please allow me to introduce the principal of the Pines Elementary School, Dr.
Thank you, Gia. We are honored to have everyone here with us today for this memorable celebration. I would also like to take this opportunity to introduce our special guests, our Deputy Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Joe Tasman, our Executive Director of Security, Dr. Chris Smalley, and our PTA President, who was also a Pine student a very long time ago, Mrs. Kate Lanos. I am honored to be here today to speak to our 5th grade students and their families. I would also like to thank everyone who made today possible. Every year, these people work very hard to put together a wonderful ceremony for our students, but I have to say, every year, they really raise the bar and make it better and better. A special thanks to our 5th grade teachers and students who have worked so hard in and outside of the classrooms preparing for today. I would also like to thank our music teachers for devoting their time and energies to making sure our ceremony is unique and memorable. Thank you to our 5th grade parents, our PTA President, Kate Lanos, and our PTA members for their countless hours in support of our students and for their tireless efforts with decorating our gymnasium and our small gym. Doesn't it look fabulous? I'd also like to thank our amazing head custodian, Tom Burke, who also helped extensively and prepared for this beautiful celebration. We always ask, one more favor, one more this, and he never, ever tires of helping us. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Beyer and our secretarial staff, Mrs. Kerr, Mrs. D'Souza, Mrs. Nichols, who worked on an amazing amount of tasks to make this ceremony very special, and who also prepared all the programs that you received today as a special memento. I would also like to thank Mrs. Tracy Zamek, who has taken a large role in shaping and organizing our entire ceremony. Thank you to all. Today, as we stand on the precipice of our young students' futures, we are filled with a mix of emotions, excitement, nostalgia, and perhaps a bit of trepidation. But amidst all of these feelings, there is one undeniable truth. We have arrived at this moment not just because of our individual journeys, but because of the collective wisdom and our support to one another that has guided us along the way. This month, as in all past years, our book of the month is dedicated to our 5th grade students. And this year, it was a book called What the Road Said by Cleo Wade. And it's my way of sharing an inspiring message to our 5th grade students as they begin their journey into Hop Hog Middle School. Reflecting on their time here, I'm reminded of the powerful words that the book says many times about the roads not traveled, the journeys taken, and it really captures life's journey and the lessons we learn along the way. And she reminds us that the road has a lot to teach us if we just pause and listen. She talks about resilience in the face of adversity and the courage that is needed in times of uncertainty and the transformative power of embracing change. These themes resonate deeply with our experiences as students navigate these challenges and celebrate their successes today. The main character asks, what if something unexpected happens? What if there are mountains that feel too hard to climb? What if giving up is easier? And the road ahead answers with this simple but yet profound phrase, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. As we leave Pines Elementary School, we hope our students carry with them the knowledge that every setback is a stepping stone, every detour is a chance for growth, and every encounter is an opportunity to learn. Today marks not just an end, but a new beginning, a commencement of the next chapter of our young students' lives. As we embark on the journey beyond these walls, let us remember our resilience, our courage, our gratitude, and the transformative power of embracing change. To my fellow graduates, or my young, soon-to-be middle school students, I urge you to embrace uncertainty with open arms, seek out challenges, join clubs and activities that maybe even you wouldn't necessarily choose, but just going out of your comfort zone could lead to amazing new opportunities, new friendships, just new learning about yourselves. May you continue to embrace every twist and turn with courage and determination, knowing that your journey is just beginning. Congratulations, class of 2024. Not only do we celebrate your achievements, but also the tremendous potential that lies ahead for each and every one of you. Here's to the roads we've traveled and the paths that you have yet to explore. This time I would like to invite Monty Pastore from class 5-1, who will share his 5-1 class memories.
To say to my fellow classmates, don't be nervous about the change.
shout, "Here we come."
Parents and teachers. My name is Riley Kirk. I would like to tell you a little bit about myself. I moved to the Pines in the fourth grade. My parents wanted to give my siblings and I a better life. We were so relieved and happy when we found out what an amazing community we moved into. We jumped right in and got involved in everything that the Pines and Hop Hill schools had to offer. I'm a member of HYO softball and basketball. I joined chorus, band, a bunch of different clubs, the school talent show, and Girl Scouts. Like I said, I have only been in the Pines for 2 years, but by far, they were the best 2 years of my entire life. Everyone in the school has always been so welcoming and kind. I never really felt like the new kid. Actually, I feel like I've been here forever. It was as if I joined a very big family when I moved here. The Pines has turned out to be a huge blessing in my life. I made so many awesome memories at the Pines. For example, I loved learning about the American Revolution in fourth grade. I will never forget when one of the kids in my class was pretending to be King George and started taxing coins from us. We were all really mad that he took our coins, but we still laughed a lot and said things like, "I'm getting those coins back one way or another." I will also never forget when we went on the fishing trip in the fourth grade. Me and my dad had a blast. I even caught a fish. I will always remember the look of shock on my dad's face. I'm so thankful he was able to come on that trip with me. I'm really going to miss my fifth grade teachers, Ms. Lukovich and Ms. Wilson. They were both so nice and they made everything so much fun. They made the whole school laugh when they dressed up as 90s boys for the school talent show. One of my favorite trips is when we went to the adventure park. Did I get stuck on a ropes course? Yes, I did. Did I still have the time of my life? Also, yes. Another one of my favorite memories was Spirit. The game where we had to pull each other on the scooters was my favorite. The best part was the way we ended the night. I loved dancing with my friends. We sang at the top of our lungs. My mouth kind of hurt from smiling so much. We also had a blast at Adventureland. Me and my friends went on like almost every ride at the park. We went on Frisbee like 14 times in a row, drank Slurpee, then went on Turbulence. You can imagine how I felt after that. Let's not go there. I still had the best day ever. Finally, something I will miss most about the Pines is walking home from school with my mom. I loved looking out my classroom window every day and seeing my house. Not too many kids can say that they lived right across the street from their elementary school, but I can. I think that made my experience at the Pines extra special. In conclusion, I know that middle school is going to be a new adventure, and to be honest, I am a bit nervous. I have a feeling that it's going to be like riding a roller coaster for the first time. I might feel scared at first, but then I just might really like it and want to go on again. I'm also kind of excited to start middle school. I think it could be a really awesome experience. Being at the Pines has taught me to be kind and welcoming to everyone. Because of this, I feel like I am ready for middle school. I would like to close with a quote from someone I truly admire, and that's Walt Disney. He says, "All of our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them." Thank you. Now I would like to introduce Ismael Morales from Class 5-3.
Funny, bright, and creative, and let's be honest, a class meme. Well, at least for my class this year. I feel really bittersweet about moving on. On one hand, I feel excited about going to a new school with new classmates and new teachers and new experiences and to start the journey of a new path in my life. But on the other hand, I've never experienced anything like this. So I'm worried it might be troublesome at first. And to do it for 3 whole years, you'd be worried too if you were me. I've made many meaningful and unforgettable memories within my 6 years of being here, like the kindergarten circuits in May of 2019, the fourth grade fishing trip at Capture State Park in June of 2023, our fifth grade Adventureland field trip last month, the school spelling bee, and so much more. Obviously, there's gonna be some things at middle school that are much different, like coming and going earlier, having your own locker to use as inventory, and even being with different people every 40 minutes when you switch classrooms. It'll take a lot of getting used to, but I know by 7th grade I'll start getting the hang of it. Oh, and slightly irrelevant, but the amount of variety in the lunch menu is astonishing. Like seriously, Chinese food, Meatball Heroes, tacos, hot dogs, even barbecue chicken. Middle school is a brand new experience, a huge evolution from elementary school. I mean, right off the bat, a school where you switch to different classes 10 times a day, and you need to put things in a locker instead of carrying around a backpack everywhere, already sounds wild. And don't even get me started on the club options. But like I said before, I'm worried and excited for all the things that can come out of this new adventure. It seems like I've already taken baby steps to be ready. Throughout the year, all of my teachers have been preparing me for middle school, like teaching us how to use lopsided lockers, how to use Google Calendar, and stuff like that. I'm sure everyone in my grade is feeling the same. It's very apropos. It feels like the time from kindergarten to 5th grade has flown by faster than a flash, and I bet middle school will feel the same. Thank you to all the teachers and staff at the Pines for everything. I will always remember you. Now I'm ready for the next chapter.
At this time, our students will receive their stepping up certificates. Classes 5-1 and 5-2, please stand.
Mazzatelli.
Nicholas Murchowski.
Aiden Napolitano.
Gabriel Orachowski.
Monty Pastore.
Austin Pop.
Mia Rosas.
Dominic Raquel.
Juliana Sanzone.
Damon Citrick.
Lucas Trevoroli.
Emmanuel Amador.
Christopher Ziegler. Congratulations, Class 5-1. You may now be seated. And now from Class 5-2, Mrs. Lukovich and Mrs. Wilson.
Whoa.
Emma Aparicio Ramirez. Jillian Aversa. Mia Barbero.
Kaden Biner.
Whoa! Go Kaden!
Rocco Belmonte.
Brody Bohaja.
Juan Jose Bonilla Oriana.
Drew Donato.
Adrian Ferris.
Amit Gajilla.
James Granshaw.
Oh, okay.
Joseph Halloran.
Iman Kamal.
Riley Kirk.
Salvatore Lima.
Catalina Lados.
Cole Perlstock.
Lexi Pickwick.
Whoa!
Mikhail Rana.
Whoa! Go, Mickey!
Addison Rogers.
Alessia Rosenbaum.
Kelly Citrick.
Salvatore Underdown.
Congratulations, 5-2, you may now be seated. 5-3, you may now stand up. Now introducing Mrs. Gumbis and Ms. Lovejoy.
Xavier Velez. Laszlo.
Elena Meenan. Ismael Morales. Gia Pagano. Isabella Salazar. Dominic Soma. Logan Sudama. Corey Wen. Congratulations, Class 5-3.
With great pride that I introduce the Class of 2024. Refreshments in the small gym and in our designated outdoor spaces.